Hi, I'm Paul Vunak. Welcome to Filipino Stick Fighting. When you talk about stick fighting to certain martial artists, their knee-jerk response is to say, well, I want to learn martial arts. I want to learn how to defend myself, but I don't really want to learn how to fight with a stick. I'm not a stick fighter. 80% of real street fights involve weapons, and anything you grab is the substitute for a stick. It could be a tire iron. It could be a crowbar. It could be a mag light. So it is my intention to teach you how to become a street fighter, not just a one-on-one fighter. One-on-one is an antiquated sport. It doesn't happen very often. 95% of battles are mass attack, ground, or weapons. So let's get out your notebook and we'll get rolling. First principle I'd like to explain to you is to differentiate between self-preservation and self-perfection. Self-preservation are the actual techniques you do to win a fight. Self-perfection are the drills that you do to develop various attributes. Relative to stick fighting, the most important thing you're going to ever learn, and remember, it doesn't have to be a stick. It could be a stick, it could be a crowbar, it could be a tire iron. Picture those big mag light flashlights. Anything some guy grabs, that's your stick. The most important move you need in this is called defanging the snake. This is the move that all the Filipino masters use. Very few people know this. I am the snake, the stick is my fang. Okay, Sing, come on up. Stay right there. Now, as I go to hit Sing, don't move. This is the range of combat that I need to hurt him. As I come in to hit him and I encroach on his head, he's gonna defang the snake. What that means is he's gonna back his head out of the way and whack me in the hand. Bam! And that is defanging the snake. So any angle I come at Sing, he's gonna whack that stick. Bam! And now I have a snake without a fang. He can kill me, or he can let it go. Now I'm gonna bring everybody out. This is just a pure demo. We haven't started the actual instruction of this tape yet. I just want you to get to see what you're gonna be training later. So you're gonna get to see my seniors moving around with rubber sticks. We're not going full speed. We don't have real sticks. We're not hitting the head. We don't have real gear. But you're gonna see what it looks like when we're defanging. Okay, everybody come on out, and go! And break. Now for the first round, I would like you guys to see what it looks like when two of my seniors are sparring single stick against single stick. You're gonna notice they're not headhunting each other. They're not blocking each other. They're staying way far away. They're putting an emphasis on defense, and they're faking going for that hand. This is the way professional stick fighters fight. Okay, let me get George. Rocky, come on out. Salute. And begin. Break. Beautiful. Now, if you notice, okay, if I could borrow this, please, the follow-ups that you just saw George doing after Rocky dropped the stick was X down, X up, floretti, redondo, all the beautiful moves that you see people doing in videos. These are not fighting moves. These are follow-up moves after the person's stick has been defanged. So that's the first principle I want you to get down. You get your head out of the way, you breathe and relax, you play defense. When the bad guy encroaches, you whack him in the hand, you've now defanged the snake. Now you have a choice. You want to kill it or let it go. Now this next round, we're gonna see double stick against double stick. Remember, with a blunt weapon, the permutations are as follows. You can have a staff, you can have dos manos, which means the stick is so heavy that it takes both hands to grab it. Say it's a 2x4 or a 4x4 or a baseball bat. Or you could have what we call sinawali. Sinawali is double stick. So in this particular round, you're gonna see us defang the snake. It's the one and only move we do in a fight. The one and only move we do, okay? And whoever gets their stick defanged, they're gonna take that posture, and the other person is just gonna do follow-ups after that. That would be the end of the fight. Okay, can I get James and Anshu, come on up, please. And salute, and we have our boundaries there and there, and begin. Good. What you just saw there, although very, very simple, is the highest level thing you can do on this planet with a blunt weapon. you have to first ascertain the range by keeping your head out of the way. From that point on, when the opponent comes in, you whack them in the hand. That is the one and only move that we would ever do in a real fight. And if you know this move, you can defend yourself against 3, 4, 5 people. When the snake has lost its fang, then you can kill it or you can let it go. Okay? So in the world of self-preservation, when your heart is pounding, when the hypothalamus and pituitary are secreting adrenaline through your body, and you're in that fight or flight syndrome, like a deer looking into headlights, and you have to be able to breathe through that, in that very moment, you have no time to try to go to your brain and remember things. What has to occur has to be visceral. And that's where, when you have a blunt weapon, you whack somebody in the hand, now they don't have their weapon, that's the one thing you're going to do. Okay? So, in the world of preservation, you have your first tool. Let's see you work it. Stick with me. All right, now this next round, we'll have double stick against single stick. Okay, my two top men, Tom Cruise, Singh Sabharwal, come on out. Salute, and begin. Great. Beautiful. Okay, now, it doesn't really matter if the guy with a single stick hits the guy with a double, or the guy with a double hits, okay, or the guy with a stick and the person with no stick. Whoever gets hit has to drop their weapon and the other guy continues on with the follow-up. This is usually what we do when we train, okay? So let's have you, when you train at home, try to train and resemble the same speed and dynamic that you see on this tape when you see my senior spar. If you're sparring too close, if you're sparring too slow, if you're beating the tar out of each other, hitting each other in the head 50 times, ask yourself, did you just see Singh and Tom doing that? So you have to do what they did. Watch the way they just sparred. These are my top two guys. If you can do what they did, you'll be rocking and rolling. Stick with me. Now we're going to digress to the world of self-perfection. This has zero to do with fighting. These are drills to develop your body mechanics and your coordination and your distancing. The first drill that we're going to use is called largo mano, long range. Paul, come on in. Now, the drill we're going to do has us doing an inward first, and then a low backhand, and then a high backhand. And as we move around, inward, low backhand, high. And break. Beautiful. Thank you, Paul. What this drill will do is teach you the mechanics, teach you distancing, and get you used to the line trajectory of a weapon coming at you, and you meet it, and then you go down and come high. All of these moves will later be translated to empty hand. Let's give it a try. We'll be right back. Now, the drill that you just saw me do with Paul Webb, the high, low, high drill, well, we're going to break in now to another drill called Sombrada. That drill was our Lago Mano drill. Now we're breaking into Sombrada. Okay, Joe, come on out. Okay, get your hand here for me. And we're gonna go high, low, high. This is the drill you just saw us do. We're gonna repeat this a couple times in a row. Now watch what I do on this third motion. I go, and I bring my left hand up and I check his hand. This is the point I need right here. And when I check his hand, then I'm gonna feed an angle one back. Joe's gonna go across and stop right there. Okay, one more time, Joe, from the top. High, low, high, high, low, high, low, and I come in, we come across, and we stop right there. Beautiful. Now we progress from Largo Mano and we're taking ourselves through the Sombrada drill. Okay, Alex, come on in. Okay, so slow again. We start with our high inward, low back hand, high back hand. When I come up to here and I put my first roof block in and then I go one, then he's gonna come with an angle four. That's the next blow. When you do that again, Al. When you come in for that angle four, I'm gonna drop my stick down. That's called the drop stick. Okay, one more time, Alex, from the top. High, low, high, high, low, and we come up to here. One and two, and that's as far as we go. Now we're gonna take it from the drop stick and we're gonna add one more blow, the angle five. Okay, Big John, come on in. We start off in Largo Mano range. High, low, high. Remember, can't reach with that checking hand. Now I take a step in with the checking hand and now we come to here, drop to here. This is where we were. And now this is our last blow. Okay, now we're gonna do this in super slow motion, John. Okay. Right when this touches, I step in with a roof block. Feed the angle one, feed the drop stick, and feed the angle five. And we're stopping right here. Now regular speed. Beautiful. We'll be right back. Now we're almost around our circle with our Sombrata. I'm gonna bring one more of my full instructors in. Marcus, come on in, buddy. Nice and slow. High, low, high. High, low. I come up to Sombrata with a roof block. Inside sweep, drop stick, wing block. Now he feeds an angle two. And with this angle comes, facilitates a shield. This shield, I just flip my angle from here. It's almost like you're saluting and you come to here. Right here and you come to here. Okay, right here, the two comes, you raise it straight up. When I get to this point, now we just reverse everything. I feed the one, Marcus does the roof. He feeds the one, I do the inside sweep. He does the four. And now we're completely around the circle. Okay, from the top, Marcus. High, low, high, high, low. I come in, boom. And this is where we were. Now I initiate the feed, you just reverse it. Roof, inside, drop, wing, shield. Then we do it again. This range is called Sombrata range because we can check. Every time we move, we can check with this hand. If we want to go to Largo Mono range, we take another step out. And now, notice we cannot check with this hand. That's the purpose of this drill, to teach you to get in and out and negotiate range. Now we're going to progress our way in to yet a closer range. The purpose of this next range and this next drill is to teach you how to use your puño, the butt of the stick. Renil, come on in, buddy. Okay, so we take it from the top. High, low, high, high, low, high. Remember, we're in Largo Mono range, but now I'm going to break into Sombrata range and we're just going to flow a little bit here. Flowing in Sombrata range. This is what we've done so far. When we get to this point, right when I'm here, the puño range that we want, this drill called thrust butt, I'm going to come with a thrust. Renil will do the same wing block. But now, instead of coming with an angle two, he's going to come with a thrust. This is the butt. Now he flips it. Put your hand in, and we come out. Thrust, butt, flip. My turn. Thrust, butt, flip. Thrust, butt, flip. I come in the center, pull it out. Thrust, butt, flip. While we're doing this, if I want to go out further, I come to here, and now we're back doing sombrada. Sombrada, we're flowing. And then if I want to go out even further, now we're back out in largo mano range. And now I'm going to break my way back in to sombrada range. Now we're going to go to thrust butt range. Thrust, butt, flip. Thrust, butt, flip. And take it out. Now we have three ranges to deal with. Long, medium, and close. Let's give it a try. Right, we're about to close this up. We're coming down to our fourth drill. We're breaking our way into the most potent and lethal range with the weapon, and that's hubud range. Hubud or trapping range is when you implement your headbutts, your knees, your elbows, all the fun things. So I'm going to invite Professor James Hundon in. He's this Wally J's absolute top man. He's my full instructor. Okay, James, come on in. We're gonna take it from the top, high, low, high. This is largo mano range, to remind everybody again. As I break in, now we're in sombrado range. Can't reach with the elbows, but we can check with the hand. Each hand can check. From this range, we come into thrust butt range. Now we're starting to put the puño in. Thrust butt flip. Thrust butt flip. Thrust, butt, flip. Now right here, when I would come in with this thrust, in lieu of the thrust, I'm coming with a puño right here. Typically when this comes, boom, this is when it gets real nasty. But instead we'll raise this and slap. Raise, slap, hit, raise, slap, hit. I can put in Wing Chun traps from here. I can come back out, but I'm not going to. We're just gonna stay in the hubud. Then we come back to thrust, butt. Thrust, butt, flip, working our way out just a little bit, and we work a little further to sombrada. Now we can't hit with the puño, but we can check, and then we go way out, and that's our largo mano range. Beautiful, James, thank you. So again, the purpose of this drill, to make you familiar with all the ranges, make you familiar with your check, when to use your elbow and your headbutts. Let's give it a try.
Mm-hmm.
Now in this next round, I'd like you to see some of my top guys just giving you an example of what we just did, going from largo mono range to sombrato range to thrust butt to hoo butt. Okay, Hector, Singh, come on out. And begin. Very nice. Now in this next round, we're going to blend self-perfection with self-preservation. The right hand will be doing self-perfection, and then I'll say switch, then the left hand is going to spar. The knife will be in the left hand, and they'll be defanging the snake. They don't get to fight with their stick, though. They're just going to keep it back here. When I say switch, they'll go back to perfection with a stick. I'll say switch, and then they'll go back to preservation with a knife. Vacillating between self-preservation and self-perfection does the following. All of your moves in self-preservation will get better because of your attribute development and self-perfection. And all of your moves in self-perfection will get more functional because of your sparring. So they work hand in hand. Okay, George, Hector, come on out. We'll start with self-perfection, largo mono range. And begin. What? Thrust butt. Largo mono. Far. Drop the stick, knife spar. And break. Beautiful. We'll be right back. Now in this next round, we're going to flow. This is a round that is like water. I am going to dictate what the participants do, and they're going to do it on the spot. Okay, Anshu Singh, you ready? Let's start with a high-low high, largo mono, break into sombrada to who bud. Go. Good. Now sing, feed for numerata. Now you feed on chew. Drop the stick, knife fight. Drop the weapon, aren't you coming for the rat? Feet to punch it. Now in our final take, we're gonna flow again. I have no idea what they're gonna do, and they have no idea what they're gonna do. Tom, sing, salute, and begin. Sparring. Sombrada. Sombrada, largo mano, spar. Drop the stick, pick up the glove, grab your knife. Sparring. Drop the weapon. Tom, do the rat. Hit the ground.
Come up, grab the knife.
Hope you enjoyed Filipino stick fighting. The purpose of this tape was first and foremost to teach you how to defend yourself with any weapon in your hand. I want to remind you that 80 to 85% of all altercations out there, somebody grabs a weapon. It is a visceral response to grab something. So now, if you have something in your hand, you know how to fight with it. Your first thing you think about is to defang the snake. Now, there are times in this tape that you're going to be watching it and you're going to see people sparring and wondering, well, what am I getting out of that? What I want you to get out of that is to see how our top guys spar. And then there are going to be times in this tape when it's going to look a little complicated. We're going to be going from largo mono to sombrato to hubbub to thrust butt. I just put 15 years in 1 hour. I want you to be a little complicated and confused. I want that. I want you to have to refer back to this tape over and over again on that area that we call self-perfection. However, if today, after you watch this tape one time, if you get into a fight, I'd like you to be able to use what you just learned, because that would most likely be defanging the snake. So hopefully, with this 1 hour, we can accommodate preservation and perfection. We can give you something to use today and give you something to think about for a long time ahead. I'll see you in our next series. Thank you.